Well, one of the most interesting questions that we always get daily, okay, almost daily, yeah, is this: how do these holes actually come out? Yet I brush every day, twice a day, but I still get these holes. And it is closely followed by this question: is there any medicine I can use that can get rid of all these bacteria that cause these holes to come out? Well, today we are going to tackle those interesting questions head on. So stay with me, I'll be right back. Welcome back. But first, if you are new to this channel, make sure that you subscribe and turn on that notification bell so that you get notified each time we upload a new video. So let's dive right in. First of all, let me disappoint you. You cannot get rid of all that bacteria in the mouth. And in fact, if you did, then you would have developed a bigger problem than what you are trying to solve. In your mouth right now, assuming that you brushed and you're a person who has good oral hygiene, your mouth actually has more than 6 billion bacteria. 6 billion. Okay? Now, a majority of these bacteria are actually useful. And these bacteria are divided into over 700 different types, what we call species. But out of those 700, it is actually just about 15 to 20 types that are harmful. And those include the ones which cause you tooth decay. So, even right now, if you got gym and gargled in your mouth, within 5 minutes after gargling, the population of your bacteria would have built back to their original number. So to answer the second question, no, there is no medicine that you can use to get rid of this bacteria, because even doing so would be harmful. So let us forget about getting rid of this bacteria. And I believe with it, amicably, having answered that second question, today let us handle the first question exhaustively. How do these holes actually develop in teeth? Alright, there are actually 5 stages of hole development, what we call decay of the teeth. 5 stages in the process of tooth decay before you even see that hole. And to set the record straight, tooth decay is not the same as having a cavity. A cavity is what you see, but decay is a process. Your teeth can actually be decaying when you are not seeing any cavity. By the time you see a cavity, the process of your tooth decay has far advanced. So let's just dive into the process. Stage number one, the formation of a sticky layer. This sticky layer is formed by a combination of the food that you eat, basically sugars that you cannot see, with ingredients which are in your saliva. So they normally form a sticky, thin layer on your teeth, which you cannot see, by the way. So this layer is the one that is going to house bacteria that is going to cause skin decay. But during this first stage, nothing seems to be going on. That formation of a thin layer and the buildup of bacteria is actually the very first stage of tooth decay. But actually, what happens is that this film traps the bacteria, and this bacteria starts to eat on the food remains on your teeth, usually sugars. When that happens, this sugar is converted into acid. And that acid starts slowly by slowly to remove minerals from your tooth, what we call demineralization. When it does that, it creates areas of weakness. Those areas, when they have developed, they form a white spot. That white spot is the earliest stage of the breakdown of your tooth. Unfortunately, that one most times is missed because it doesn't give you any symptoms and it is not easily visible. So after the formation of this white spot, the second stage will have already been completed. if this film, what we call the plaque, is not cleaned out adequately from your teeth, it even traps more and more bacteria and more food substances and forms what we call tartars. When your teeth have developed tartars, now this is dangerous, because the tartars are like a house that is protecting a large number of bacteria to make your tooth decay progress even faster. Because the higher the number, the more the acid they will produce, and the faster they will remove minerals from your tooth, and the faster the hole will develop. Once the bacteria has produced enough acid to dissolve your minerals until it has penetrated through the top layer of your tooth, which is called enamel. And by the way, enamel is the strongest bone, and also it is the strongest part of the tooth. Now, once that has been penetrated, the process now enters a softer second layer, which we call the dentine, which has a lower ability to resist to decay. So here, the minerals are lost faster, the decay progresses faster, and the breakdown is also faster because it is softer. The invention of the dentine actually concludes the third stage. At this stage, usually, is when somebody develops sensitivity. The reason is simple. This second layer has small tubes that are not visible, but these tubes communicate with the inside of the tooth, which has nerves and blood vessels. So it sends sensations to the nerves and blood vessels, and that is what you report as sensitivity. That is the very reason why we always say, if your tooth has a feeling, then it means it needs help, because you have seen how far the process would have gone to cause you that. Stage number four. Now, once the process has gone beyond the enamel and it has gone beyond the teeth, the next part is the pulp. Now, this pulp is the one we refer to earlier when we say the tubes from the dentine communicate with the inner part of the tooth, which has nerves and blood vessels. So once the process has reached that area where the nerves and blood vessels are, the acids will irritate these nerves, and the infection will also cause a swelling inside these nerves. But inside the tooth, we just have the nerves and blood vessels. Surrounding these blood vessels and the nerves is just a hard part of the tooth, and this hard layer is not capable of expanding. So as these blood vessels and nerves swell because of the infection, they have nowhere to move to. Now, this means the pressure builds up in the blood vessels, and these blood vessels are going to press against the nerves, and this is what people usually refer to as pain, because that's exactly how the pain comes. The nerves and blood vessels cannot expand beyond the tooth, so it builds up the pressure, and what you feel as pain is as a result of that pressure. And actually, pressure can be so severe, and it can be referred to your jaw, it can cause you headache, it can even be referred to your neck. And most people usually come at this stage. And this is also the reason why they always say dental treatment is expensive. The truth is, you have come a bit later, and that usually requires a different kind of treatment as compared to if you had come in the first stage. Stage number five. After the invention of the pulp, you have reported that pain, but some people for some reason may not come for the treatment. So maybe they'll take painkillers or antibiotics or something, then the infection cools a little and then they feel some relief. Then they feel the problem is gone, yet it is not. These are the ones who come when the tooth decay has reached stage number five. And that now means that the infection has gone beyond the tooth. It seeps through the end of the roots into the surrounding tissue and forms a swelling and forms pus. And this is what we always refer to as the dental process. And depending on when you will come, this could actually lead you to tooth extraction. And in our previous video, we talked about the effects of losing your tooth. please make sure you have this one. Otherwise, you will suffer those effects that we talked about. That result from the extraction. Finally, you know how exactly your tooth decays. Right from the time of the formation of that thin, sticky film to the formation of the white spot as a result of the invention of the enamel, to infection spreading to the dentine, to infection moving to the pulp, and eventually forming pus at the end of the root of the tooth, what we call the dental abscess. That is how that tooth actually is. If you have any other questions, please leave them at the comment section, and I'll be glad to address them. If you find the information in this video to be useful, please make sure you give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't yet subscribed, make sure that you subscribe, turn on that notification bell so that you get notified each time we upload new informative video. Thank you for watching. See you next time. Bye bye.